I'm sure you've all heard that sound before. Anywhere a great horned owl can find a place to roost during the day, they begin their day at night, just as it gets dark. Forest edges, shelter belts, parks, even in cities. Owls have always brought a mixture of emotions, from fear to endearment. They are instantly recognizable and unmistakable. But how many people have actually seen an owl in the wild? With their largely nocturnal, solitary, and secretive habits, they've been associated with witchcraft and sorcery, or as the messengers of death. This is Jillian, our 12-year-old teaching team member of Raptors of the Rockies, and my opening call was nothing quite that sinister. I was saying, I'm an attractive great horned owl seeking a hot mate to start a family. And when I was a kid, I could hoot up barred owls back in Cincinnati, right in my backyard, by imitating their signature call. It's hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo- And any given night, I'd have about a half dozen birds coming close enough to check me out. That's how I started my lifetime love of raptors. Now, humans are keyed into a visual world where seeing is believing. But when we think about birds and we listen closely, we find that hearing is believing. They are talkative animals. With sound as a primary means of communication, we hear that dawn chorus of songbirds every morning in the spring. And that's the male songbird soliciting a mate. He's using a specially chosen phrase, the song specific to him, specific to the species. It could be like his fingerprint. And beautiful bird songs have been likened to human phrases. Here's a few. Sweet, sweet, I am so sweet. That's the yellow warbler. This one. If I see you, I will seize you and I'll squeeze you till you pop. Warbling vireo. But my favorite is the olive-sided flycatcher. Quick, three beers. Makes me thirsty. Now, the male songbirds are generally saying to anyone that'll listen, I can provide with for you, let us breed. And with his beautiful plumage, postures, flight displays, these are all added signals seen during the light of day. He's also marking his territory with songs and sights around the perimeter, like erecting an imaginary fence. But what about those birds that call at night? A great horned owl's resonating hoot can be heard for a half a mile. Amazing sounds, but we can't see them. For us, it's mysterious because it's dark out. Now, vocalizations among the owl species range from a tedious to calls that resemble a yipping puppy, a cuckoo clock, a bouncing ball, or a raspy whistling sweet. My favorite quote is by Desmond Morris, and he said that an owl's hoot is reminiscent of someone pretending to be a ghost so as to frighten a small child. He said their shrieks, screams, screeches, and squawks would lead a person to think they were standing outside of a torture chamber. Okay, how many times have you been watching the horror movie? The kids are in the graveyard, and it's a full moon. And it's Halloween, and you're scared, and it's spooky. And then you hear that eerie call. Who is going to die? And that's actually right on, because that's what great horned owls do very, very well. These are the apex predators, the premier predators. These are not vegans. They eat everything, from insects to rodents to rabbits to animals the size of a skunk. With their upright posture, their forward-facing eyes, their blinking top eyelid, eyelashes, and their beak that looks like a nose, they resemble humans. Or the other way around. For some people, especially those that have seen owls, they appear to be wise and kind. For others, they appear to be pondering the woes of the world. They really aren't. They aren't. What they're saying tends to be pretty mundane. Like, woo, Honey, how was your winter? Where do you want to nest this year? Or, this is my domain? Or, does anybody live here? Is this territory occupied? Or, I'm a nice 2-year-old male great horned owl, wondering if a single female is within earshot. Now, great horned owls don't migrate, and they stay on the breeding grounds 12 months a year. For most birds, an important part of courtship is building a nest or refurbishing an old one. But for owls, it's vocalizations. Owls don't build nests. They pilfer. Okay, they borrow the nest of another bird, like a hawk or a raven or a crow, or they use a broken off top of a tree. So they don't build their nest. Vocalizations are important. Owl pairs are basically just getting reacquainted since the last breeding season. Now, owls have different voices, and the female has a higher pitched voice, even though she's the larger of the two sexes. The male has a little bit deeper voice, a little more drawn out, a little more resonant. You can tell them apart, and they'll call back and forth, or they'll sing in duets. And owls, like songbirds, are saying the same thing. They know each other by voice. I've been doing education programs with Raptors of the Rockies for 27 years. And in every single program, I ask the audience to go out and hoot up an owl. Young and old alike, we ask the audience members to hoot up an owl. One of my favorite little cards I got in the mail was from a second grade girl that says, "It's fun to speak owl." So I'm going to ask you to cross your hearts and promise me you'll leave your cell phones, your electronic devices, all that stuff at home, and go outside and experience nature firsthand. You can communicate with owls, and they'll talk back to you, and all it takes is a simple trip to the out of doors. But just make sure it's really dark. So I'm going to hoot, and then you're going to hoot. Okay? Gals, you're a little bit higher. Guys, you're a little bit deeper. We go like this. Now you do it. You nailed it. And I've got goosebumps. Thanks.